Hi everyone, welcome back to our new session of the UiPath. In this session, I will explain you how to integrate or configure Salesforce application or Salesforce login in UiPath so that we can perform automation activity on Salesforce. So you can see here, for integrating, we'll need Salesforce login credential, or we have to create account on Salesforce. And in addition to that, we'll also need activities should be installed in our UiPath. So you can see here, I've already installed salesforce.enterprise package.activities. After installing this, you're able to see Salesforce in UiPath team console, and different activities are available here. So after creating, we will also need application to be created inside the Salesforce so that we'll automate the activity based on that application requirement. So for HTTP, we have to create Salesforce login credentials on developer.salesforce.com. Don't worry about that. I will mention this link for creating the account in Salesforce. After creating the account, you have to create one application, REST application for that. Make sure you should create developer.salesforce.com login. Otherwise, if you are creating basic login, you are not able to automate any of the REST application, because basic application login will not have the REST API component. Make sure to login in or create the account in developer account. So after creating the account, you can see here, it's developer login credential. Next, for configuring, we will need four credentials here. Now I'll show you, I've already integrated my account. I will show you for testing the connection. Once I will click, you're able to see valid connection is established. So for this, we'll need consumer key, consumer secret key, password, security token, and username. So I will show you one by one how to get this credential for entering this and checking the connections. Let me delete here and I will show you from the beginning. Delete this activity, go to home and open any test automation project. I've already opened, because of that I'm directly jumping here. Go to the activity panel and drag one activity from extension package. Now you're able to see five components should be required for valid connection. So next we'll go to our Salesforce developer login. Once you will click on here, you can see settings. Once you will click on the setting, you are able to see here, reset my security token. I have already reset it, I am saved in my file, because of that I am not going to reset it again here. So once you will click on here, it will reset your security token and send an email to your Gmail account. Once you will receive that security token, just copy and paste it from your email ID. I am copying it because I have already copied it from my Gmail account. So once you will get the security token, enter the security token detail. Next, we'll need username. So whatever username you are using for Salesforce login, copy this username and enter it to here. After entering this detail, we'll need password as well. So I'm not entering the password. Once we'll get consumer key and secret, then we will add it to here. Next, just go to selecting setup. Once we'll click on setup, it will open new tab for you. Go to apps, app manager, Once you will click on the app manager, you can see your new connected app. Create one app for your testing. Rest UiPath test 2. Enter your email ID, whichever email ID you want, the notification and all. Enter this detail. Check the enable authentication setting, and inside the callback URL enter https://localhost:8080. After entering this, provide full access. Select this and add it to full access here. So you, after adding this, just click on the save. Once you click on the save, you will get notification allow from 2 to 10 minutes, because after creating your application, it will take some time for reflecting. So whenever you are creating, wait for the some time, and then after configuring, you can check your connection. I am clicking on the continue. After clicking on the continue, you can able to see consumer key is here. So I am copying this consumer key and pasting it to my detail page. Next, we'll need consumer secret. So click on here. After clicking on this, you're able to get consumer secret number from here. Copy this and enter into consumer secret tab. Now we have done. In addition to that, for using this application, we need to manage some policies as well. So click on manage. We don't need to check anything here, just click on edit policies and select some configuration. So permitted users should be all users may self authorized, and next we need to click on relax IP restriction. After checking this, just click on save button, and now you can able to access your application or connecting your applications. So next we will need to enter the password. So I am entering my password of Salesforce login. Now you can see all the warnings are resolved. Just change it to server type as a production. After changing this, you can test the connection. Because we have created the application sometime before, because of that it's not connecting. So wait for some time and click on connection, test connection. You're able to see here valid connection should be established for your application. So whenever we are creating any application, wait for some time, it will configure an update in a database, and once you enter the detail here, check the connection. After checking, you're able to see your connection is successfully established. Now it's not connecting. Keep the server type as production and click on test connection. You're able to see your connection is successfully established. But this way we can integrate or configure Salesforce login in UiPath. From next session onwards, I will explain you how to automate the thing in Salesforce login by using UiPath. Thanks for watching this. If you have any queries or comment, please comment in the comment section so that I will check and revert with the resolution. And main important part, don't forget to like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.